Get ready to match the star. Robert Moore. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Adrienne Barbeau. Richard Dawson. And Fanny Flagg. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the star of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
What's going on here?
Holy mackerel.
That's what's going on.
I would like to
roses are blooming in Picardy.
I think she should go home and change it. Because
you
it is September and the leaves could fall.
Have they taken all your good lines,
They've
Brett?
They've taken all my good stuff.
Yeah.
Why don't you go home? Well,
Benny.
Yes.
Do you have anyone who comes in and prunes those? Or...
Such a delightful person.
You need mulching.
Certainly.
You had to wear a sweater too, eh?
Heading forward.
Okay, folks.
Yes, if
Hi,
you can't
Bob.
Bring the Thanks. Mountain to...
I'm wearing pants. Okay. Aren't you sorry you're sitting up there? All right, let's say hello to our two players. Shall we do that now?
Okay.
Phil Perrell and Carol Rakestraw. Hello there.
How are you?
All right.
Hi, how are you?
Okay, good. Good. Now... Phil is the current champ. He's won $3,450. We started this game yesterday. We got to the middle of round one. You had your question. Your question is about to come up. Are you ready for it?
Ready.
Okay, we'll give it to you in a moment or so, but first, we've got to give you this. Okay, here we go. I'll push this button and reveal this question, which we have for you, Phil. Listen carefully. This is it. Everybody plays. Jane said, Tarzan finally got rid of my sister last Saturday night. He sent her on a blind date with a blank. That's how he got rid of my sister. Tarzan said that. Jane said, Tarzan finally got rid of my sister last Saturday night. He sent her on a blind date with a blank. Put your glasses on so you can hear me better. You're finished? Everybody finished? Okay, here we go.
I have it now. It's all written down. Placed
now,
in slot.
Phil, Jane said... Tarzan finally got rid of my sister last Saturday night. He sent her on a blind date with a blank.
With an ape.
With an ape. Down, 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 boy. What do you got there? Okay, show. Monkey.
Monkey and ape. There's a match. All right, there's one for you.
You didn't say it.
It's all right.
I didn't have to.
Yeah, but Chico never talked. Brett?
He does a wonderful imitation of a girl, doesn't he?
Yes.
I said tiger.
Last night he sent her on a blind date with a tiger. Yeah.
Now that's it.
She'll get you in the parking lot after the show if you're not careful.
There's going to be a mass mugging.
Charles, ape.
Chimpanzee. Would
Chimpanzee
you
and an ape. Okay. What do you say, my dear?
Well, I think I've been out with him too, a gorilla.
There is another one. That's three for you. And Richard.
Well, they're very friendly, all of those monkeys.
Chimps and monkeys and apes.
Yeah, that wouldn't guarantee that she wouldn't return.
Right.
But if you have a date for dinner with a hungry cannibal, you're in a lot of trouble there.
That's right. Okay. How about you?
Yes.
Long-stemmed American beauty Rose.
Well, she was very, very tall, Jane's sister, so he got her a date with little Pygmy.
Fanny.
I don't get it, but I don't want it. Okay, here we go. Where are we? All right, push the button and ask you to make a selection.
Yes. A again.
Everybody plays because she didn't score at all in the first round. The Godfather said, Christmas. Oh, it hurts. This is a Christmas. If you're on my good side, you get a bucket of vino. But if you're on my bad side, you get a bucket of blank. Oh, that's very good. You're a smart kid, you know.
What my song was.
I don't know if anyone's going to get...
Was Roses Are Shining on Fanny Flag.
Roses are shining on Fanny Flag. Doo-dah. Da-da. All right, Carol. The Godfather said...
At Christmas, if you're on my good side, you get a bucket of vino or wine. But if you're on my bad side, you get a bucket of blank.
Water?
Water.
I didn't hear the first time.
Do you really understand the question?
No, we'd like you to go over it.
Well, no, but if you don't understand it, we got to give it to you until you understand. The Godfather said, you know who the Godfather was? He said, at Christmas, if you're on my good side, you get a bucket of vino, which is, as you know, is wine. But if you're on my bad side, you get a bucket of blank.
Lead.
Lead?
Yes.
Can't do that? Well, we got to go with your first answer, the judge says, even though you didn't understand it. So water is the answer.
Wait a minute. Asked her again? Ask her again, and she said lead. And I have lead. And I think that that's your answer. You asked her.
You know, I'm going to get the Godfather after you. Well, the thing is, I should not have asked her,
but you did ask her.
I broke the rule, you see. Okay, Brett.
I hate that little troublemaker from the East. I said blood.
Blood. Okay. Water is her answer.
Blood.
We got blood. You got to match the three remaining ones to stay in the game, and here we go.
I said blood.
All right. So that means Phil Perella's the winner. Come on down, Phil. Okay, there's $100 for you. You all had blood over there. Okay. Well, lead wouldn't have really helped you that much anyway, would it, Carol? Sorry to see you go. We've got a gift for you, Carol Rakestraw, together with our thanks for being here with us on Match Game 74. Goodbye, Carol. Now, Phil, you hang on there for a minute or so while this thing turns around. We'll do a little business, and then we'll come back, okay? All right. Okay. Are you ready, Phil?
I'm ready.
All right. Now we're going to have a go at the Big Money Super Match here, where you can win over $5,000. You got $35.50. You're doing okay. We polled a recent studio audience, got their best response to this. Blank bones. Now, you know the $500 answer is $250 and well, you know all that, don't you? All right. Let's find out who's going to help you here.
Charles?
Charles, how do you feel on that blank? Blank bones. Blank bones.
Mr.
Bones? Okay. You're going to get wings too.
Mrs.? I got it.
Mrs.?
Right after they get her, they're going to get you. Go.
Robert?
Robert.
Chicken.
Chicken bones.
Chicken bones.
All right. There's a couple of great ones for you, Phil.
Richard?
That's not an easy one. The only thing
What's
that song? Them bones?
Yeah,
I have a perfect one.
What's the title of that song?
The title of that song.
Can you ask questions?
It's my show. Get your own show if you want to holler. The title of the song you're trying to think
of
is...
I love it when you're firm with them.
The title of the song you're thinking of is Dry Bones.
Okay, that's what I'll say.
Is that what you say?
Yeah.
Okay. So you've got Dry Bones, Mr. Bones, and Chicken Bones, Phil. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own.
I'm going to give you one of my own, Lazy Bones.
Lazy Bones. Another great song.
Why did he buy the rest?
Wow.
Why don't you get your own show, too, Phil? You're thinking of it?
Right.
All right. Lazy Bones, the one you're looking for. Let's find out if it's up there. You're on your own here. Is it under the $100 response? No, it is not. Broken Bones is indeed under there. Still looking for Lazy Bones. Here we go with the $250 response. Dry Bones is Richard's answer.
Well-known song.
It's okay. Gonna be Lazy Bones.
Here we go. Let's see if Lazy Bones is under the $500 response. Lazy Bones!
Right there now.
You know, I think that's the format for his new show.
Since he's gotten money, he's become unbearable.
He was a little meek and mild fellow.
Money. Money really arouses you, doesn't it?
It does.
Your libido is 10 times as strong now as it was a week ago, Phil.
Hope so.
Okay, so you've got the $500. Now, Phil, you're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. If you win another $5,000, you'll have $9,050.
Wow.
Are you ready to select one celebrity?
I think I am. Charles.
Charles, you're elected. You get ready to write, Phil will face me. Here is the $5,000 question.
All right, kids.
Okay.
House blank. House blank.
It's a hard one.
Finished. He says it's a hard one. Well, we'll find out right now. Phil, what answer would you give us that you think will match Charles' answer? House blank.
Houseboat.
Houseboat. Sounds like a reasonable answer to me. Charles, does he match you?
Sorry, I said house beautiful.
House beautiful. Name of a well-known magazine. All right, so Phil, you're up to $4,050. And you're going to meet another player. Are you ready to meet her?
Yes, I am.
Okay, here comes Arlene Primisario. You know, Phil, this is our week, isn't it?
Yeah.
Arlene, would you like to tell us a little bit about yourself, please? Wait a minute. What have you got there?
I brought you a bear.
You brought me a bear?
Yeah, they wouldn't let me get a live one, so here's a little caged one.
Here's a bear.
I was up in Sequoia with the bees.
Oh, isn't that nice? National Parks, California, a bear. A little bear in the cage there. Can you see that? Yes, there he is.
It's trained.
He has green eyes.
He has green eyes? How can you tell?
I looked.
Oh, you looked.
Arlene, well, he does. I should point out his weakness is money, but thank you anyway.
Well, I'll just leave him right there.
Oh,
okay,
yeah.
Thank you very much. Now, where are you from and all that, Arlene?
Huntington Beach. and I'm married to a very wonderful husband.
Mm-hmm.
And father.
He's a husband and father?
Yeah, little girl 2.5, and I have son 11. And I'm nervous.
Are you really? There's no reason to be nervous. We're a friendly bunch, aren't we friendly?
Give her
yeah, like six barracudas.
It's weird.
Would you like to hold this bear for good luck?
No, he might bite me.
Oh, all right. What'd you say is weird?
I watch you at home in the kitchen, you know, every day.
Yes?
And now here I am. It's like Twilight Zone. Yes.
We're not weird, are we? Are we a friendly bunch? We're just like old shoes around here.
You'll be
here.
Fine. Really.
All right, good luck, Charlene. I'll push the button, and we'll get started.
Isn't Brett much prettier in person?
Well, don't make her lie on the air.
Let's shall we begin, folks? Okay.
As she brought your present, give her both A and B.
All right.
It'll be a little obvious.
Please make a selection.
Oh, I don't believe this. A.
A. All right, here we go. Everybody plays.
Okay.
Hey, I got a little limerick for you.
Oh, okay. Good.
A newlywed lady named Glunk said marriage is really the bunk. The wedding was splendid, but the honeymoon ended when I found I had married a blank.
Oh, it's my own story again.
A newlywed lady named Glunk said marriage is really the bunk. The wedding was splendid, but the honeymoon ended when I found I had married a blank.
He bold as a hawk, she soft as a dove.
All right. You understand the rhyming scheme there, Arlene?
I should say something that rhymes with that.
With a newlywed lady named Glunk. You ready? Said marriage is really the bunk. The wedding was splendid, but the honeymoon ended when I found I had married a...
bum.
Bumpkin. You flunked poetry in high school, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, you said bum. Found I had married a bum. That's her answer.
Well, your husband is now at home, probably listening to that answer, and he's going to get very drunk.
Found I had married a drunk. Okay, Brett.
I came a little closer to the bone, as it were. I said skunk.
Skunk. We understand. Charles?
I came closer to the girl on my right. I said clunk.
Clunk. What'd you say, Vian?
I agreed with that girl. I said skunk.
You said skunk. Okay. Skunk and drunk are two good rhyming things for that limerick.
A real stinker, I'm afraid.
A real stinker, yes. Okay, Fanny?
When she had married a poor man. No. I said, gracious, I was meant to say clunk.
Okay. All right. Arlene, so you didn't get a Ryan there with the word bum, and that's your first round question. Now, yours will come up a little bit later, but right now, friends, we got to stop and pay attention to this. Okay. Are you ready, Phil?
I'm ready.
Okay. Phil's first round question reads as follows. Superman said, "Before I leap a tall building in a single bound for good luck, I always kiss my blank." He said, Superman said, "Before I leap a tall building in a single bound, I always kiss my blank."
Kiss my blank.
For good luck.
Okay.
Oh, I know you.
Don't think too hard, Charles. You're going to strain something.
We don't have to worry about Charles ever thinking too hard.
All right.
Oh, dear.
Put it in the slot. That's the way, Charles, like we taught you to do. Now, Phil. Superman said, "Before I leap a tall building in a single bound, for good luck, I always kiss my blank."
Shh. Cape.
Cape. He said, "Kiss my cape." Robert?
That's right. There's a big, he wears a big cape with an S on it.
Right. Cape. Cape. That's it. There it is. Okay, Brett.
I thought his S was on the front.
Yes.
I said, "Kiss my S."
Okay. Okay. Charles?
Kiss my ass!
I'm glad you used your deep voice. What did you say, my dear?
Well, I know Superman isn't married, but I couldn't think of anything clean, and I couldn't figure out how to say it like that, so I said wife.
Kiss my wife. He is not married.
No, I know he's not.
Did
but
he,
I was
did
stuck.
He marry Lola?
Lois Lane.
Lois Lane.
Lois
Lane.
Lois.
No.
See how much I
she
hear.
Left him no, for Wonder Boy.
She left him for Wonder Boy. I yes. thought it was. Now, Richard, would you like to?
Yes, he does kiss an S. It's his secretary, Lois Lane.
Lois Lane.
It's right here.
Right there. Yes.
Then she gets turned on enough to go and see that little copy boy. They have a great time.
Or he does.
What do you say, Fanny?
Well, I knew that he didn't marry Lois Lane, and I said his mother.
Always kiss my mother before I leap over a tall building.
You should.
Okay.
Good luck.
All right, so
one
that
nothing.
Was one for you. One, is that all? Yeah, that's all. Okay.
Well, I meant look at it compared to Arlene.
So it's one to nothing at the end of round one. We go to round two and ask Arlene to make a selection.
A.
A. Is that what you had last time?
Well, I live in apartment A. My daughter's Alicia, and that's A. And my name's Arlene, and that's A. And I'll
so you've got to stick with A.
So with your luck, when you go back, your apartment will have been cleaned out.
Yes.
Person named Dave.
All right, here we go. Tim said, "I keep having this terrible dream that my boss is a dog and I'm a blank." Tim said, "I keep having this terrible dream that my boss is a dog and I'm a blank." Think about that while they're finishing their answers up here.
No cheating. Stop on each other.
My boss is a dog.
Oh, yes, I know there's something there. I just can't figure it out. I don't
And I'm
think.
A blank.
Oh, my job.
Oh, yeah.
No. You're cheating.
Yeah. Can't cheat
my
in this show.
My boss is a dog.
Tim said, "I keep having this terrible dream that my boss is a dog and I'm a..."
Oh!
It was frightening. He's
quickly.
Raising two children.
Yes. All right. Now, Arlene. Tim said, "I keep having this terrible dream that my boss is a dog and I'm a..."
I don't...
Cat.
Oh.
A cat. All right, she said cat. That's not bad. What do you say, Robert?
Well, I think the worst... Well, maybe...
Hydrant. Okay.
Hydrant.
Yeah. That's
a
it.
Hydrant.
What'd you say?
But my mind doesn't run along those channels at all. I said dog catcher.
Dog catcher. Okay, cat's the
don't
answer,
don't be vicious
Charles.
With the bell. Just ring it.
Hydrant.
Hydrant. That seems to be the answer, ABM. What'd you say?
That was mine, too.
Fire hydrant. Okay. And Richard.
Well, it may seem to be the answer, but it isn't. The answer is cat.
Cat. There's one.
said bone.
Bone.
Mm-hmm.
So you got one match there. And that means you need one to win the game. And we'll see if that happens or not. But first, we've got to see about this happening. Our time has expired for today. So we're going to have to pick up at this point.
You're the bum out of starts applauding when I say the time has expired. I think he's expiring.
Okay, it's 1-1 in the middle of round two. I'll remember that. I've got it written down someplace.
What's the score?
The score is 1-1.
Very good.
Isn't that clever of me to remember that? How much time we got here? 20 seconds. He says 20. He says 10. What do you say, Pat? 7, 6. Well, we'll see you next time. Gene Rayburn for Match Game 74. Goodbye. Are you ready for it?
I'm ready.
Okay, we'll give it to you in a moment or so, but first we've got to give you this. Okay, here we go. I'll push this button and reveal this question, which we have for you, Phil. Listen carefully. This is it. Everybody plays. Jane said, Tarzan finally got rid of my sister last Saturday night. He sent her on a blind date with a blank. That's how he got rid of my sister. Tarzan said that. Jane said, Tarzan finally got rid of my sister last Saturday night. He sent her on a blind date with a blank. Put your glasses on so you can hear me better. You finished? Everybody finished? Okay, here we go.
I have it now. It's all written down. Placed
now,
in slot.
Phil, Jane said, Tarzan finally got rid of my sister last Saturday night. He sent her on a blind date with a blank.
With an ape.
With an ape. Down, 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 boy. What do you got there? Okay, show. Monkey.
Monkey and ape. There's a match. All right, there's one for you.
You didn't say it.
It's all right.
I didn't have to.
Yeah, but Chico never talked. Brett?
Does a wonderful imitation of a girl, doesn't he?
Yes.
I said tiger.
Last night he sent her on a blind date with a tiger. Yeah.
Now that's it.
She'll get you in the parking lot after the show if you're not careful.
There's going to be a mass mugging.
Charles, ape.
Chimpanzee. Would
chimpanzee
you
and an ape. Okay. What do you say, my dear?
Well, I think I've been out with him too, a gorilla.
There is another one. That's three for you. And Richard.
Well, they're very friendly, all of those monkeys.
Chimps and monkeys and apes.
Yeah, that wouldn't guarantee that she wouldn't return.
Right.
But if you have a date for dinner with a hungry cannibal,
you're
in a lot of trouble there.
That's right. Okay. How about you?
Yes.
Long-stemmed American beauty Rose.
Well, she was very, very tall, Jane's sister, so he got her a date with little Pygmy.
Fanny.
I don't get it, but I don't want it. Okay. Here we go. Where are we? All right. Push the button and ask you to make a selection.
A again.
A again. Everybody plays because she didn't score at all in the first round. The Godfather said, Christmas. Oh, it hurts. This is a Christmas. If you're on my good side, you get a bucket of vino. But if you're on my bad side, you get a bucket of blank. That's what the Godfather said. Oh, that's very good. You're a smart kid, you know.
What my song was.
I don't know if anyone's going to get
was Roses Are Shining on Fanny Flag.
Roses are shining on Fanny Flag. Doo-dah. Da-da. All right, Carol. The Godfather said,
At Christmas, if you're on my good side, you get a bucket of vino or wine. But if you're on my bad side, you get a bucket of blank.
Water?
Water.
I didn't hear the first time.
Do you really understand the question?
No, we'd like you to go over it.
Well, no, but if you don't understand it, we got to give it to you until you understand. The Godfather said, you know who the Godfather was? He said, at Christmas, if you're on my good side...
Get ready to match the star, Robert Moore, Brett Somers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Adrienne Barbeau, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flagg. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74! And now here's the star of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn!
What's going on here?
Holy mackerel!
That's what's going on.
I would like to roses are blooming in Picardy.
I think she should go home and change it. Because
you
it is
that.
It is September and the leaves could fall.
Have they taken all your good lines,
They've
Brett?
Taken all my good stuff.
Yeah.
Why don't you go home? Well,
Benny.
Yes.
Do you have anyone who comes in and prunes those or such a delightful person.
You need mulching.
Certainly.
You had to wear a sweater too, eh?
Heading forward.
Okay, folks.
Yes, if you can't bring the mountain to...
I'm wearing pants.
Okay. Aren't you sorry you're sitting up there? All right, let's say hello to our two players. Shall we do that now? Okay. Phil Perrell and Carol Rakestraw. Hello there.
How are you?
All right.
Hi, how are you?
Okay, John. Good. Now... Phil is the current champ. He's won $3,450. We started this game yesterday. We got to the middle of round one. You had your question. Your question is about to come out. You get a bucket of vino, which is, as you know, is wine. But if you're on my bad side, you get a bucket of blank.
Lead.
Lead? Can't do that? Well, we got to go with your first answer, the judge says, even though he didn't understand it. So water is the answer.
Wait a minute. You asked her again?
Ask
her again, and she said lead. And I have lead. And I think that that's your answer. You asked her? Right? You did ask her.
You know what? I'm going to get the godfather after you. Well, the thing is, I should not have asked her. But
you did. But you did ask her.
I broke the rule, you see. Okay, Brett.
I hate that little troublemaker from the East. I said blood.
Blood. Okay. Water is her answer.
Blood.
We got blood. You got to match the three remaining ones to stay in the game, and here we go.
I said blood.
All right. So that means Phil Perrell is the winner. Come on down, Phil. Okay, there's another $100 for you. You all had blood over there. Okay. Well, lead wouldn't have really helped you that much anyway, would it, Carol? Sorry to see you go. We've got a gift for you, Carol Rakestraw, together with our thanks for being here with us on Match Game 74. Goodbye, Carol. Now, Phil, you hang on there for a minute or so while this thing turns around. We'll do a little business, and then we'll come back, okay? All right. Okay. Are you ready, Phil?
I'm ready.
All right. Now, we're going to have a go at the Big Money Super Match here. Where you can win over $5,000. You got $35.50. You're doing okay. We polled a recent studio audience, got their best response to this. Blank bones. Now, you know the $500 answer is $250 and a hundred. Well, you know all that, don't you? All right. Let's find out who's going to help you here.
Charles?
Charles, how do you feel on that blank? Blank bones. Blank bones.
Mister.
Mr. Bones? Okay. You're going to get wings, too.
Mrs.
I got it.
Mrs.
And right after they get her, they're going to get you. Go.
Robert.
Robert.
Chicken.
Chicken bones.
Chicken bones.
All right. There's a couple of great ones for you, Phil.
Richard.
That's not an easy one. You know anything?
No,
like, what's
not.
That song? Them bones, them bones.
Yeah,
I
have a perfect one.
Well, what's the title of that song?
The title of that song.
Can you ask questions?
It's my show. Get your own show if you want to holler. The title of the song you're trying to think of is...
I love it when you're firm with them.
The title of the song you're thinking of is Dry Bones.
Okay, that's what I'll say.
Is that what you say?
Yeah.
Okay. So you've got Dry Bones, Mr. Bones, and Chicken Bones, Phil. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own.
I'm going to give you one of my own, Lazy Bones.
Lazy Bones. Another great song.
Why didn't he
Why don't you get your own show, too, Phil? You're thinking of it?
Right.
All right. Lazy Bones, the one you're looking for. Let's find out if it's up there. You're on your own here. Is it under the $100 response? No, it is not. Broken Bones is indeed under there. Still looking for Lazy Bones. Here we go with the $250 response. Dry Bones is Richard's answer.
Well-known song.
It's okay. Gonna be Lazy Bones.
Here we go. Let's see if Lazy Bones is under the $500 response. Lazy Bones!